Definitely coal fired plants, or rather coal usage in Indonesia itself, will still be there. And frankly, I'm still upbeat, and I still I'm still quite positive about the whole situation. It's a matter of time, because you see, this 35,000 gigawatt project, it may not complete on time. It may not, you know, because you look after going to the conference, you see the problems, you see what people tell you. We have land issues, we have land acquisition issues, we have finance issues, we have many issues that we have to overcome. So, but eventually, I feel that the 35,000 watt megawatt program will be achieved, although it may take a little bit longer than the 5-year plan. Right?
For the gas power generation, is because the gas is expensive now, so mostly it's will be used for picker or the load follower, and that's the direction that PLN is taking now. Although for some private company, we still depend 100% to gas, and also we try to diversify to other fuel which is cheaper, like coal. The outlook for gas itself is quite promising, with the government effort to bring in the local LNG supply to domestic market. I think that's the right way to do.
If we have a look at the most of the projects in Indonesia, because solar photovoltaic, yeah, photovoltaic is a bit expensive technology, need to be used for generating electricity. So most of the project coming from the government through APBN. But now, since 2013, when the government released their feed-in tariff, it becomes the new start, and it's becoming booming now because the government allocate money to buy the electricity, and most of the industry will come and build the factory here, and people will enjoy electricity from photovoltaic power plant.